This video is brought to you by SucceedSchool.com. With complete lessons and resources, assessments, learning plans and schemes of work for students, parents and teachers, for revision, for catch-up, or just to get ahead in class, visit SucceedSchool.com now for your free trial lessons. SucceedSchool.com. Learn to succeed. Hey class, I'm Mr Thornton and I'm going to help you succeed in your GCSE and IGCSE. In the second video in this two-part lesson on standard form in science, I'm going to show you how we type standard form into a scientific calculator. In this video, I'm going to assume you're familiar with standard form notation. If you're not, then please check out my previous video by clicking here, where I explain what it is and how things are a little easier in science than in maths. Another way things are easier in GCSE and IGCSE science is that you are always allowed to use a calculator, every test, every exam. Unfortunately, I've found in the past that my students were quite unsure about how to use standard form and tended to overcomplicate things a bit. But modern scientific calculators actually make it really easy. I'm going to demonstrate first on this Casio calculator, which is one of the most common types of calculator used by students today. I can then use this to demonstrate the same method as you do it on other brands of calculator, such as Texas Instruments. This isn't the newest make of Casio calculator currently available, but all of their scientific calculators for well over a decade have had this feature. It's this button labelled times 10 to the X. This is a brilliant little function which takes all the hard work and thought out of working with standard form. If I wanted to type 20 kilometres in standard form, that's 20 times 10 to the 3, remember, I'd just type 20, hit this button, which you can see gives us our times 10 to a power, and then enter my power, in this case 3. That's it. Again, enter your number, hit this button, then enter the power. It's that simple. If I hit the equals button, you can see it converts this for us automatically. It even protects us from common mistakes. So if I type 20 times 10 to the 3 times 2, watch what happens. The calculator is smart enough to know to multiply the whole number by 2 instead of multiplying the power by 2. All the same, if I were you, I'd pop some brackets around the term just for my own peace of mind. These Casio calculators even handle other operator errors. If I type the wavelength of my laser from the previous video, 532 times 10 to the minus 9, I should really be using this smaller minus in brackets just here to indicate a negative number. You can see that the calculator has converted the number into a form your math teachers would prefer here. Incidentally, if this was an answer to a question and you wrote 5.32 times 10 to the minus 7 meters instead of 532 nanometers, you would still get the mark. It's exactly the same quantity. This is actually very common at A level and degree level, so I've never seen a GCSE or IGCSE science paper which didn't accept an answer like that. Now, as I say, I should really have used the other minus symbol in brackets here. But if I deliberately hit the wrong one, everything still works out just fine. If you have an older Casio scientific calculator, you might not see this button, but it's probably still there. On older Casios, it was labelled EXP for exponent, but it worked in exactly the same way. However, not all calculators have this feature. Texas Instruments calculators, for example, often don't have it. But that's because they have another way to do these calculations, which is, frankly, almost as simple. In fact, this calculator has it too. Casio just gave you more than one way to do things. If you don't have a times 10 to the power X button or an EXP button, then you need to look for a symbol of the number 10 being raised to a power. It's almost always the alternate function of the button labelled log. On this calculator, it's right here, and I press the shift key to access it. On this Texas Instruments TI-30 calculator, it's right here, and pressing the second function button lets you access it. To type 20 kilometres, I type 20, as before, hit the multiply key, then press the alternate function key to access this function. As you can see, it's automatically typed the number 10 and raised it to a power. I just need to type my power in the box here, and when I hit equals, you can see it's worked out the answer. The process for typing 532 nanometers is pretty much the same. Again, this calculator isn't picky about which minus symbol I use, but give it a try on your own calculator to make sure. Different brands are likely to have different tolerances for errors which a user might make. Again, I'd strongly recommend putting things in brackets to make sure you don't accidentally multiply by the power of 10 instead of the number you're interested in. So that's standard form for science. The key things to remember are 1. Make sure you know your prefixes. You need to learn them off by heart. This table, listing all the prefixes you need to know, is available in the succeedschool.com free trial, the link for which is in the description. 2. Just switch the prefix for the matching power of 10. Don't worry about how many digits you have before the decimal place. As we saw in the previous video, scientists don't care about that. And 3, type the number straight into your calculator using either the times 10 to the power x button or the 10 to the power x function, which is probably the alternate to the log button. And that's it. Something which I know can look kind of tricky is actually really straightforward. Learn the 7 prefixes you need to know, spend a few minutes practicing typing the numbers into your calculator, and suddenly questions which a lot of other people will be put off by will be something you can score some easy marks on. It's a skill which you can pick up in no time, but it's worth a disproportionately large amount of marks. Take a little time to practice, and I bet you'll wonder why you ever thought it was hard. I hope that video really helped you. If it did, it'd be great if you let me know in the comments. Remember to like, subscribe, and hit the bell to get a notification the next time I upload a video. If you check the description, I've got links to my revision guides, to SnapQuiz, that's my revision website and app, and to succeedschool.com. That's my website with full lesson plans, schemes of work, and end of unit tests for both teachers and students. I've also got links in the description to my Twitter, my Instagram, my Patreon if you want to support the channel, and there's links to my other YouTube channels, Not School and Not School Plays. You can also click just here to subscribe to this channel, and you can click here to check out this related video. Good luck in your GCSEs and IGCSEs, and thanks very much for watching.